Greetings, Earthlings! My name is Zero Jake, and welcome back to Avorion. So, last episode, we changed our ship out so that it is now titanium instead of iron, because titanium is superior. And we've also got three mining turrets now. Much better mining. What else do we have? Yeah. A lot of other stuff. So, what happened last episode what happened between last episode and this one is I've been mining. As you can see in the top left, I have 17,000 iron and about 2,800 titanium, and all that stuff. I also have, if we go to inventory instead, so player menu inventory, you can see there's a lot more stuff than there was before. This is because whilst I was mining, pirates appeared. I equipped some salvage turrets to salvage the ships after they've been destroyed. I got a few modules, so I got a few new guns. You know, we've got a double iron salvaging turret, we've got a double iron mining turret, another double iron mining turret in a different layout. What's the difference? Something. This consumes energy, this does not. Right. Ah, that's why that does more damage. Right. That makes sense, because it uses energy. But it's less efficient, so therefore I'm not using it. Well, I might use it on another ship, but not this one. We don't need it. And, you know, a double chain gun, which is currently the only gun that we've got. And then, you know, quite a handful of modules. That's basically the loot that I obtained from doing hardly anything. And also this. So the current modules that we've got is we've got this turret control system, which adds an unarmed turret slot. These are unarmed turrets. These are mining turrets. And we've also got a radar upgrade, which gives us a deep scan range, whilst consuming power, of course. And I'll show you what that means in a minute, but some other things that are useful is this C43 object detector, which highlights objects of interest, such as the secret stash that we found in episode 2, and basically it will highlight objects like that for us automatically. When we're in 5.6 kilometers. We've got an engine upgrade which increases velocity and acceleration for increasing our energy consumption. We've got a velocity security control bypass which reduces our generated energy by half but increases our velocity by something. We don't know. We've also got a C43 object detector like that, which detects claimable asteroids and wreckages. So if we do that instead, then that should do something. My thinking is that it would show me any asteroids that have materials in, but it doesn't, which is kind of annoying. What does it do? Detects claimable asteroids and wreckages. Displays a notification when interesting items are detected, whereas this one actually highlights it instead of telling me that it's there. So that's more useful. We've also got a scanner range increase, which, you know, increases our scanners. I'll show you that in a second. We've got a thing that gives us a massive cargo hold without me having to build them. We've got another deep sector scan. We've got a turret control for armed turrets. We've got some hyperspace hyperspace upgrade, which is absolute rubbish, because these are petty. The petty ones we don't even care about. We can get rid of them safely. But yeah, so we're going to put in our deep scan upgrade, and we are going to go to the map. Ooh, the map. Interesting. So yeah, this is the map of the game, and as you can tell, there's the galaxy. We're on the very, very edge of the galaxy because of lore or something. So we can hover over things and we can see what's there. We can see that I have one ship here. The Universal Church has some ships here. The blue guys have some ships. Purple has some ships. Also says there's 1,500 asteroids. Which that number is decreased since I have mined quite a bit. You can see some blips on the radar, by the way. These green ones are unknown energy signatures. Yeah, so these are usually star systems. So systems that you can go to and they have things in them, such as stations or ships. Basically anything that's green has stations. Anything that's yellow, however, which is given to us by the lovely, lovely upgrade that we have, is actually where a ship is. We don't know what, It could be pirates, it could be asteroids, it could be loot, it could be horrible Cthulhu, we don't know. And then finally we have these beams here, which represent wormhole travel. So if I get out of here, oh, pirates are attacking, so where are they? There. Meh, we won't care about them. So if I go and find the correct area, oh, noting that I found this. If you scroll out, yeah, it will go into a tactical view. And if you've got a captain on a ship that you own, you can order them about RTS style. It's also useful for seeing the entire sector. But what I'm looking for is I'm looking for this, which is the jump gate. So I can scroll back in, scroll back in. So I'll head over to the jump gate. Yeah, so each jump gate, there's always a pair, and the links are these things. And so there is a system over this way, which we can jump to using the gate, but the gate costs about 300 credits to go through. We have that. But we're not going to do that. Not right now, anyway. We're sticking around this area. But we've got some hidden mass signatures, and therefore I'd like to go to them. So what we do is we right-click on the sector that we want to go to and enter the coordinates into the navigation computer. And so that's just going to stand by. It's going to calculate the jump route, as you do. And then once the jump route is calculated, we can then look towards it. And really, I wish that that wasn't so bright. It's like we've got lens flare generators. Anyway, yeah, so we can do that, and then we can press space to jump. And one loading screen later, and we enter this, which apparently does have mass objects here. Or at least it did have. We have no clue. Just need to keep our eyes out. But so if we scroll out, we should be able to see stuff, right? That. What the hell? Okay, I believe that is a wormhole. Interesting. Well, holy hell. So that's a wormhole, which is a massive, massive jump, which will take us over there. Oh, that's very useful. That's a very lucky find. Yeah, just move. But we're not going to go through it, because if we go through, we're probably going to die due to death and things. So we're actually instead going to head back. So if we look over there, we should see the wormhole. And if we go through it, it's essentially like a jump gate. You don't have to pay for it. It's all that. Yeah, we'll go there later. So that's very good. So we're going to head back. Here we go. Ah, hello. The adventurer. Am I off on an adventure too? Indeed. That's great. I'm sure we can help each other out. If there's anything you would like to know, just ask away. Okay, can you give me some tips? Of course. Closer you get to the center of the galaxy, you'll find better materials to build your ship. You'll be able to build energy generators, we have that, or parts to protect your ship like integrity blocks or even shield generators. The first thing you should do is get some titanium. Done that. And be wary of no man's space around here. I hear there's a pirate leader who terrorizes everyone who strays too far from civilized sectors. Let's talk about something else. What's happening around here? Okay, plot. This is plot dump, by the way. 200 years ago, there was a cataclysmic catastrophe which nearly ripped our entire galaxy apart. Everybody just calls it the event, which is, you know, descriptive. What happened? People don't know for sure, but legend has it that an unsurmountable ring of torn hyperspace fabric appeared around the center of the galaxy. That pirate ship is getting very close, it's annoying me. And now our hyperspace engines can't pass it to get to the center, meaning it's cut off from the rest of the galaxy. Since the event, nobody has managed to get near the center of the galaxy. Yes, that's kind of the point. The worst part is that the event also spawned hyperspace rifts throughout the galaxy, which makes navigation difficult. And then there's the Zotan. I'm just going to call them Zotan. It's like a Xenon, because it's X, but never mind. Go on. Nobody knows what they are, and they don't answer to any intercom calls. When you get too close to them, they start attacking. They have been around since the event, and people say that they were created by it. But there is also a bright side. Together with the event, a new metallic element called Avorion, hence title, has appeared. I've heard rumors that there's lots and lots of it at the center. apparently it is the perfect element for building spaceships. It's robust and light, and its energy properties are crazy. But so far, no one has found much of it, but I'm going to change that. I'm sure that means I'm going to change it, not you. I'm going to fly to the center of the galaxy. I'm going to overcome the barrier, and then I'll mine all the Avorion so I can get rich. Well, your quest for getting rich, it sounds very similar to, I don't know, space pirates and zombies. Because guess what was at the center of the galaxy there? Zombies. Not the best. I wish... How do you want to overcome the barrier? I'm not sure yet, but there has to be a way. Yes, because it's a video game. Besides, it wouldn't be a very good adventure if everything was clear from the start, wouldn't it? Yeah, I definitely know that. Yeah, I don't look at the wikis all the time so I know what's ahead of me. Yeah, definitely. I wish you the best of luck on your journey. Thank you. You know what? Here. Have this. It's an upgrade for your ship that allows you to scan for hidden sectors. You'll have to install it in your ship menu for it to work, but you can only install upgrades into a real ship. It doesn't work with drones or fighters. The green blips in your... Yeah, I've said that already. With this upgrade, you'll be able to scan for hidden secrets. They'll show up as a... Yeah, we have those. Thank you. What are you doing? We kind of know that. Thank you. I'd like to leave now. All right. Good. Right. Now that that's... Oh, yeah. You're part of the Holy Church of something. Yeah, so we already have an upgrade that gives us this. And we already found a wormhole, which is excellent. So yeah, this gives us a deep scan range of 2 for 0.3 gigawatts. This gives us a deep scan range of 3 for the same efficiency. I think I'll stick with the one we have, thank you. But yeah, so let's go to another one, because the first one, you know, that's not going to have anything useful for us. Hopefully we won't find any pirates, because that's going to be hilarious if it is. Right, we're here. And there's pirates. I feel safe. Except I don't. Because there's one right next to us. Okay, we're going to have to boost away. Luckily, we have a stupid amount of speed. And so we should be able to outrun any pirates. Yes. Here's a question. Is that planet moving? The answer is yes. So therefore, the planet is technically an object. So we could head towards the planet. Yeah, just keep moving. We should have our hyperspace. No, keep moving. Okay, right, let's chart a course. Let's get out of here. Because this ship is not built for combat. It's not built for anything except mining, really, and getting places fast. Right, there we go. Back to civilization-ish. Yeah, so we have one more, which is over there, which we're not going to do, because that's not, you know, something I'm interested in right now. Instead, we are going to go through this lovely jump gate that we have over here. I'll have to pay money for it, but as you can see, we have money. We have the means. So, yeah. And currently, we're cooling down from hyperdrive. Well, no, we're not cooling down from hyperdrive. I've already done that. So yeah, if I go pee and then go to ship, it should say how long it takes to cool down. 23 seconds. Yeah, that's not much. Hyperspace reaches 2.5 sectors and radar reaches 14. Yes. So, here's the thing. About these upgrade slots, we can actually get more if we increase the size of the ship. So we could have this thing, which will allow us to see 5 sectors. We could use the... no, where's the thing? Here. That doesn't increase jump range though, so that's going to be something. In fact, because I'm curious, so we've got our iron stuff, noting that the toolbar resets every time you log in, which is kind of annoying. So we've got, you know, titanium, and then we've got neonite, I think, yes. Right, so we've got a thing called a, so let's have a look at the new stuff. So there's a turret rotation lock, which basically makes fixed turrets so that they don't actually move. Shield generator, energy, and integrity field, and hyperspace core. So we need Neonite in order to increase our jump range. Interesting. And also, you know, we've got glowy blocks, and then there's Trinium, which acts as a hanger. Anything else? Does Trinium add anything else apart from that? Holographic, okay. Then we've got some more stuff. We've got hangar, dock. Dock is there always. Hyperspace. Computer core. Increases processing power for more system upgrades. Interesting. That sounds useful. And then we've got Ergonite, which gives a new thing. Actually, it doesn't seem to actually give the hyperspace core. It might just be like much better at resisting things. And then we've got Avorion, which doesn't give any new blocks, I don't imagine. No, okay, that's good. So yeah, we can build hyperspace cores later, which will allow us to increase our jump range. But for now, we're going to have to be stuck moving around using the wormhole network, since that's going to be the fastest way. And here we are, in a new system, with new territories, and what have you. Now the question is there titanium here? And the answer is probably going to be, probably not. Because titanium, there is titanium. Excellent. Basically, I need more titanium in order to increase the size of our ship so that we can have more systems, and more guns, and probably combat, I don't know. In fact, integrity field generator. I want to see what that does. So, we've got this thing up here which I built for more crew members, since I needed more people to man the guns. But what we can also do is we could go over, get titanium, and have a look at this integrity field generator. What does it do? So let's decrease that to minimum, decrease that to near minimum. If we do that, would that allow me to shrink you even more? Yes. Step, reduce to 2.5, since that's going to make it much easier for me. And then we want to decrease you down to that. Oh, this is not helpful whatsoever. Yeah, stupid piece of... Let's change that to 5, shall we? And change that to 5, and then we can go underneath and place the integrity field generator there. Except it's blindingly bright here, not conclusive to safe operations. So if we shrink that down to that size, that should be the same size as this, except it's not. We don't want to decrease that, we want to decrease this. Thank you. Place it here. And that should give us an integrity field. Right. What does that do? So, technically, we should be able to bump into this, and then we won't take damage. He says, breaking off the front bit of the ship. Well done there, well done. You are such the fool. Let's repair that. I'll need to have a look at what that actually does, but yeah, so an integrity field generator should do something. I think it's to help against projectiles rather than, help against lasers rather than projectiles, possibly. I would say who knows in a kind of jokey way, but someone does know. Mainly the developer and anyone who has played more of this than me. Yeah, I'll probably come back to the sector to mine additional stuff. I'll just mine this asteroid so that we can get more titanium. Because we're going to make a ship upgrade somewhere in the near future so that this thing's bigger and therefore scarier and therefore something. I was going somewhere with that. What's this? A trading post. Ooh, interesting. What do you do? Do you have a thing? No, you don't. Buy, sell goods. Use, do stuff. Okay. That's quite a bit. That's not going to be useful for me. There's another Jumpgate over there. Let's actually scroll out so I can see what's going on. So we've got a Jumpgate here, which heads south. We've got a Jumpgate here that heads north, That heads west northwest. I can't actually change the camera angle, but I can move like this. Right. Everything's confusing because I don't know any of the controls for this. I only know how to scroll in and out. Okay, right. So let's scroll back in. Okay. Let's go to map. So we can see where the Jumpgate network is heading us, and we want to head closer because then we can get all the fun stuff. In fact, there's actually some hidden mass signatures, and we might get lucky. So let's wait for that to happen. Whilst that's happening, then we will do something. I don't know. Right, let's jump. Right, we have entered the system. Doesn't seem to be any enemies, I don't think. Just seems to be a massive asteroid field. Okay. Yeah, it just seems to be a massive asteroid field. That's fine. Okay. Hello, everybody. Mobile merchant Nexi's Catharsis is here. You don't say. Are you following me around? Right. Anything interesting around here? I hear there's a smuggler around here who's got his hand on some Zotan technology. Apparently, his hyperspace engine is extremely advanced and he can jump anywhere in the entire galaxy. That's fun. Right, what do you have? You have... oh, random stuff. You don't actually have anything useful for me. Where's your home sector? Right, so technically what it's done now is it's said, hey, this is the home sector of someone. What's this? I don't know. So that says asteroids, that says asteroids. Let's continue looking, because looking definitely won't get us killed, right? So, in the early game, basically, you want to mine, you want to explore for random loot, because random loot is going to be very, very valuable, until you can get a proper ship. Right, here we go. We seem to have a smuggler. Greetings. Interested in earning some money? How much? About 500,000 to a million, depends how fast you are, and if you can get the job done. Does this mean you're interested? Yes. Good. You have to take the cargo and bring it to the checkpoint I just sent you. Should be easy as pie. Where? There? Well, we have a thing there. And how long do we have? So if we go player and... No, not player. Here. Missions. Easy delivery. 60 minutes. Oh, that sounds fun. Right, let's do that. Okay. Technically, we're smuggling, so we should kind of not get trapped by the authorities. Yeah, just calculate the jump route and let me jump through the planet. So, what we're going to do is we're going to head to the... well, we're going to go through the wormhole thing and see where that gets us. Hopefully, we won't die, because if we do, that's going to be fun. Recharging. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Engage, Captain. And thus, Captain Jake of the Avorion set off on his adventure to make Mad Buck. Tune in next time to see how that goes. But until then, my name has been Zero Jake. End transmission.